Administrative Tribunals Act 1985, Section 5 within bracket 4 within bracket A, Chairman of Tribunal Functions. Stop. This provision does not enable the judicial member to act as an administrator. This provision does not enable the judicial member to act as an administrative member or vice versa. Stop. If the chairman is a person who was administrative member, then under section 5 within bracket 4 within bracket A, if he goes to another bench, he can sit on the bench as an administrative member, but certainly not as a judicial member. Stop. The same will be true with regard to the chairman who is a judicial member. Stop. Para. Delay condoned. Stop. Learned counsel for the petitioners refers to section 5 subsection within bracket 4 subclass within bracket A of the Administrative Tribunals Act and submits that who is otherwise a judicial member can act as an administrative member also. Stop. The said provision reads as follows. Stop. Para. Notwithstanding anything contained in subsection within bracket 1, the chairman may, in addition to discharging the functions of the judicial member or the administrative member of the bench to which he is appointed, discharge the functions of the judicial member or as the case member of other bench. Stop. Para. In our opinion, the aforesaid submission of the learned counsel is not correct. Stop. The chairman may be a judicial member or an administrative member. Stop. All that this subclass permits is that the chairman can function at more than one bench. Stop. This provision obviously had to be included in order to enable the chairman to function at different places when he goes on tour. Stop. This provision does not enable the judicial member to act as an administrative member or vice versa. Stop. If the chairman is a person who was an administrative member, then under section 5 within bracket 4 within bracket A, if the another bench, he can sit on that bench as an administrative member, but certainly not as a judicial member. Stop. The same will be true with regard to the chairman who is a judicial member. Stop. We do not find any infirmity in the order of the High Court. Stop. The solution to the problem in hand is to make early appointment. Stop. The special leave petition is dismissed. Stop. There. Constitution of India 14 and 16. Scope and ambit of articles 14 and 16 vis-a-vis different classes of employees considered. Stop. Constitution of India articles 14 and 16. Army Order 11 of 1987. Study leave classification regarding granting to commissioned officers and not to other categories of officers. Stop. Held that the order in question is not violative of Article 14 of the Constitution. This appeal is directed against the full bench decision dated 24-12-1993 of the High Court of Himachal Pradesh in Civil Writ Petition number 747 of 1991. Stop. For the purpose of appreciating the point urged in this appeal, we may briefly state the facts. Stop. The respondent appeared in person before the High Court. Stop. In this court, though notices were issued, He did not appear, hence the matter was taken up for hearing in his absence. Stop para. The respondent is a Havaldar oblique clerk in Indian Army, and he was interested in pursuing his studies further for obtaining higher educational qualifications such as post graduation in law, but he felt handicapped because of the provisions contained in Army instruction, namely Army Order Number 11 of 1987, according to which only regular commissioned officers get extraordinary leave subject to certain conditions, and not persons like the petitioner who is not an officer. Stop. Therefore, he challenged the said army order before the High Court on the grounds of discrimination, basis, etc. Stop. Para. Before the High Court, the present appellants took the stand that study leave is granted to a regular commissioned officer to get higher studies having a direct and close connection with the spheres of his duties. Stop. It was also stated that the nature of duties of junior commissioned officers and non-commissioned officers is different as compared to regular commissioned officers. Stop. The appellants took the stand. Matter of grant or refusal of study leave is purely discriminatory. Stop. The allegation of discrimination was denied. Stop. It was also stated that for junior commissioned officer and non-commissioned officers, the institutions of the appellants where these officers are trained. Stop. We find from the judgment that a prayer made on behalf of the present appellants for adjournment was denied on the ground stated in the judgment, and the writ petition was disposed of without hearing the learned counsel for the appellant. Stop. The High Court, relying on the decision of this court, came to the finding that the duties of clerical nature are also important, and therefore rejected the stand of the appellants, and held that higher education is also necessary for clerical staff. Stop. Para. Accordingly, High Court, the present classification for granting study leave was not founded on an intelligible differentia, and the same has also no relation to the object sought to be achieved, and benefit of study leave must be made available equally to all classes of above officers of Indian Army. Stop. Para. We have heard Mr. P. N. Misra, learned senior counsel for the appellant, before entering into the reasoning given by the High Court. Let us now first consider the scope and ambit of Articles 14 and 16 vis-a-vis different classes of employees. Stop. We may refer to all India Station Masters and Assistant Station Masters Association, Delhi and others versus General Manager, Central Railways and others, AIR 1960 SC 348, Article 16 of the Constitution. The Constitution Bench of this court inter alia held that equality means equality as between members of the same class of employees, and not equality between members of separate independent classes. Stop. Similar views were expressed by the Constitution Bench of this court, J versus the State of Uttar Pradesh and others, AIR 1961 SC 1245, and in paragraph 15 it was inter alia held that equal protection of the laws does not postulate equal treatment of all persons without distinction. It merely guarantees the application of the same laws alike and without discrimination to all persons similarly statuted up in the state of Mysore and others versus P. AIR 1968 SC 349. This court considered the validity of the rules and the inter alia held that it is well settled that though Article 14 forbids class legislation, it does not forbid reasonable classification for the purposes of legislation, and when any imposed rule or statutory provision is assailed on the ground that it is contravenes article, validity can be sustained if two tests are satisfied, namely classification on which it is founded must be based on an intelligible differentia which distinguishes